Alright folks, episode 81 is being brought to you by my YouTube channel, Bionic Anson. So we are just continuing trying to see where is that Hey, I'm trying to see where you are guiding the I don't see the maybe when the party's have a chocobo. I think maybe it's inside the mountains. That's the only reasonable conclusion.
You can do it.
Get your ass out of here.
Just like that, okay?
Alright, Aerith was able to master the you know, the ATB ward, so it's time to that ceremonial step. So this is the best Let's get a chocobo first. I think the chocobo is integral to this. What the heck are those balls? Well, I don't think we can... we can access those things without a chocobo. What the heck are those big balls?
Me, really?
Ah. Oh. Oh, Final Fantasy VII Rebirth. Every move here requires a mini game. Well, I don't know what kind of feeling they want the gamers to feel once they completed the platinum of this game, but alright, at least there's a mini checkpoint already. Hmm. You have to be really patient in this. Alright, obviously I don't want that, I don't want episode 81 to be a Alright, so at least there's a checkpoint here.
Good bird.
And that's the reason why Odin, Barnabas Storm. Hey.
Another life spring.
All right, folks, so
great! Got it.
Alright, as we keep hammering away and just trying to you know, get as many regional information as we can before we proceed to the story proper here in Nibelheim. Except Cypher. Square, square, triangle, triangle. Ah, we still got it, folks. Odin.
Synchronization. Let's hope our investigation of other shrines goes as smoothly.
Yeah, as of now, even Chadley can say that, you know, things are going smoothly. Too smoothly, in my liking, folks. All right, episode 81, folks. We're just trying to, you know, get as many world intel as possible. Get this out of the way and. All right, let's try to look at some of the things that can be transmuted. Well, as of now, I have not seen any proto-relic information. Have we seen any info of this Nibel region? I've not seen any. Is now available. Let's see here. Alright. It is said that beyond the desolate Yagrops at Mount Nibel lies the Island of the Dead, a view there approach its slope. Indeed, even plight life struggles to find foothold here, and with tumbling boulders and rocks like the constant threat, the locals see little reason to make such a perilous journey. Many of the mountain caves are filled with Mako buff vapor, and the inner reaches contain Mako springs and naturally formed material. Shinra's search for a new energy source led them to Mount Nibel, and its abundant supply of Mako made it ideal site for the world's first reactor. Although it played an instrumental role in the proliferation of Mako energy, the Nibel reactor's time in the spotlight was brief, and it now operates at greatly reduced capacity. The shadows of Iyad formations at the foot of Mount Nebel, the village of Nibelheim, had little to offer to the outside world. However, their quiet existence will change dramatically with Shinra's discovery of vast reserves of Mako within the mountain. The company's efforts began with the construction of Shinra Manor on a plot of leased land. It was there that the head of research and development, Professor Gas, and his assistant, Professor Hujo, pioneered studies on Mako and Genova. Shinra's financial investment delivered the people of Nibelheim from poverty. Their newfound happiness and prosperity will be short-lived, though, as the entire village was burned to the ground and countless innocents slaughtered by Sephiroth. A perfect reconstruction of Nibelheim was later erected on the site in secret and now serves as a treatment center for victims of Mako poisoning. So, is that the reason why those black-hooded guys are, you know, going there? The treatment center. Alright folks, we're near the end of episode 81. I'll just continue this on the next scheduled episode. And right now, these are... Okay, this is another Odin Divine Intel. Who the hell are these guys? Wait, let's be we'll do it on the next scheduled episode. Not right now. Corel Region Nibel, Cosmo Canyon Gongaga, Chunon area. And it's really crazy that the first game has predominantly been in Midgar, but really this rebirth opened up the game. So good job in really giving so much content to really make this sequel interesting. Well, there's treasure here. Whenever there are rabbits, alright folks, so as I've said, I'm just continue this on the next episode gameplay. If you love this gameplay folks, kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel Bionic Hansing and hit that notification bell so you'll be updated to my latest uploads of Final Fantasy 7 Rebirth, gameplay analysis, trailer reaction, and sometimes live streaming for all the games that I've been playing for trophy hunting. This is ripe for a big boss fight. I can feel it, so I'm not gonna go there yet. Thank you, everyone. God bless you all, and stay safe out there, folks. So in the next episodes, my trophy quests are the following. I'm gonna try to finish that Mugel side quest, and I'm gonna try to obtain also an A ranking in the piano here in Naval Region, and I think that's A rich team. And compared to Red 13th, that piano team in Cosmo Canyon, it's really just simple, a walk in the park. All right, again, folks, thank you, everyone. God bless you all, and stay safe out there, folks.